Welcome back. We had so much fun on the last video that we thought we would continue the conversation, talking about finances, of course, and how they can be a blessing to you, your family, community, the body of Christ, and all of humanity if they're managed properly. And we've been talking about smart money moves during Christmas. And you know, that segues us into our next smart money move during Christmas. And that is giving of our time, giving of our efforts, especially to charitable organizations. And there are all kinds of volunteer opportunities to help those who are traumatized during the season, to listen to people, talk to people, food banks, you name it, there are all kinds of opportunities. And this also is helpful for people who battle depression and oppression during the holiday seasons. And I'm talking about believers who are also fighting these things. But sometimes turning our attention on someone else and helping them actually helps us.
That's true. That is so true. You know, it's important to realize that we live in a world of people. And if you live in a world of isolation, you miss the value of the people, the diversity around you.
Yes.
The beauty of God's creation.
And that segues into our last smart money move. And that is, never forget that during the Christmas season, celebrate Christ. And having a relationship with Christ is really the foundation. And you know what? We talked about things that money can't buy. Well, if we're really honest, sometimes what we're trying to buy is our own self-esteem, feeling good because we can buy things, having people look up to us because we've got the money to spend, even though we actually may not be able to afford it. But what we really need is to know that we are greatly loved. And we can find that in Christ. And once we find that, we then have the strength to not be so driven to fulfill whatever emptiness there might be inside of us.
That is so important. When you think about how much time we spend trying to impress other people, even the people in our homes, if you just pause for a moment and think, how much debt have we gone into because we were trying to make someone happy? And if you had taken a moment, used the wisdom of God, realized the power that comes with loving God and the gift that Christ has given to us, and you said to yourself for a moment, no, I'm going to do something different. Like I said, there may be poked out lips for a little while. But if you are not drawn into the anger, drawn into the disappointment, and you can have a plan that you are working to show God's love in your family, to those you love, now those plans will bring about joy in the long run. And the love of Christ will be seen in your home. So now this is the way you bring Christ back into Christmas. And if we begin to love one another and show that love in our home, we'll begin to spread this good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ in just the way we live and treat each other.
Yes.
And that means in our politics, our economics, our relationships. Don't get drawn into the bitterness that's so often the case after Christmas, during Christmas. And it's a very high divorce season after Christmas.
Wow.
People get divorced over finances.
Yeah.
And if we're just wise.
Do you mind if we just have a quick prayer right now? Because I think some people, there are 10 weeks to go before Christmas, but you may already be feeling the pressure. You may already be feeling the stress. So if you just stop just 1 minute, we just want to say, Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for our brothers and for our sisters right now. And we pray that in the name of Jesus, they receive godly wisdom during this period. Godly wisdom in all areas of their life, but especially in finance. accounts. Lord, for those who may need to open savings accounts and begin to prepare now,
yes,
in advance, give them wisdom and discipline to do so. For those who may need to have serious conversations with their loved ones to say that this year we are not going to be able to splurge like we have in the past. Give them wisdom and give them courage, God, to do what they need to do. Lord, we pray peace over them. We pray joy in their lives because Christ has come.
Yes, Lord, and we pray that you would give them alternatives. Once they are able to restrain from the spending, give them alternatives that will just bless their homes and bless their lives. In Jesus' name we pray.
In the name of Jesus, amen. Pray that this helps you. God bless.
God bless you.